Hey guys, well today I'm going to show you a really light, simple look because today I don't have a lot of time. I have to like clean the house and pick up my mom and brother from school and stuff. So today I'm just going to show you something really simple but nice to go out in because it's really light. Okay, so I've already put my powder on, but I found this Clean Color American Icon Wet Dry Big Shadow. It's a shadow, but it's really big. You guys can see it. So I've been using this on my cheeks a little bit because I like how pink it is. I don't know if you can see how pink that is and bright. And since I have darker toned skin, I like to use that. Also, I still have this. I'm going to use part of this because this actually goes on really, really light. So I don't know if I want something darker. You can, you know what I suggest for if you're really, really on the go or really, really fast, you just want to do it. Buy something like this where it has four lines and just mix it all together and put it on your cheeks. But if you have more time like I do right now, just do what I'm doing. So I'm going to take my darker colors again, like I usually do, and make my brush like a fan, because I can't find my other brush. Tap it off a little bit, or blow it off, if I do, and go right in the crease on both sides. I'm using a lot of blush today. I don't know why. Okay. Alright, and then I'm going to take this color. My other brush, and I'm just gonna put it in there. And I don't really like how this is, so I'm just gonna take it. And look, I look like a clown right now with it. With how, do you see how much that is? I don't know if you guys can see it. You look like a clown. I know that looks crazy, but you're gonna take your brush and just blend it all out. Give myself a nice color. Do you see how nice that looks? Like a nice wash color on your cheeks so you look alive. I'm going to take the cargo again and I'm going to take the lighter colors and highlight my cheeks. And now my face. Okay. Hard to see. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys this eye look. You can do it very, very simple, or you can do it a little bit harder. I'm just gonna be taking this color. It is my L'Oreal Hip High Intensity Pigment 924 Visionary. I really love this color. I think I did a tutorial, I'm not sure. Oh no, I deleted it. It's like really bronzy and nice to just like wake up your face. So what I'm gonna do, what you could do is just take this and put it all over your lid and leave it. If that's what you want to do, if that's, you know, it's, if you're not, you don't have that much time. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my duo crayon thing, I don't know what it is, shadow. I'm gonna use the shadow part and I'm just gonna highlight up here. That's crazy. And blend it. And blend it down with your finger. And I'm just gonna set that with actually my foundation, because my foundation powder, it's really light and it doesn't even really cover that much, but I don't really need a lot of coverage myself. I'm gonna tap that off so there's very little. I'm gonna tap it off a little more. Very, very little. And I'm just gonna, so it's just kind of like my natural color with a little bit of shine to it. Very little. And then I'm just going to take the color and work it on my lid. What you could do after, you could take a darker brown shadow to give yourself a little dimension, but I don't think I'm going to do that today. Okay, so this is how it looks. It's really pretty in the sun because it's gold and it's really light, so you don't really notice it too much unless you're like in the sun. Right now you can notice it a lot because I'm right by my window. But like I said, you can create more dimension with a fluffy brush. If you haven't seen my last tutorial, take any fluffy brush you really have, just make sure it's like really fluffy like that, and you dip it in your brown, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna sweep it on your natural crease. This is your natural crease, and you're just gonna sweep it and swirl it and blend it out so it's not too dark. And always when you take your powder, especially dark powders, you dip it in there, and if you see there's a lot, tap it off and then there'll be less. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill in my brows. You're going to take any angled brush you have, or you could even probably use like a pencil brush you like, whatever you like. You're going to take it and you're going to put it in any brown that you like for your brows. Oops. And follow the naturalness of your brow. Move it a little dark. Easy fix though. See how much better that looks? You just do a little bit of shadow in your brows. And please do not use a like crayon or something. I'm not a crayon, but you know, a makeup crayon like this for your brows. Honestly, it doesn't look natural. It looks a lot more natural if you use a shadow. And it does make a big difference. Like Joey's little sister started to do it, and her eyebrows just looked amazing last time I saw her. It like totally changes your face. You don't even realize it, but it does. See? That's what it looks like. And now I'm going to show you the lips. Okay, so for the lips, I'm using this clean color retractable waterproof lip eyeliner. It's like that color. It's like a pinky color. If you live in El Cajon, it's in that like $5 store next to Fresh and Easy. If you don't, I don't know, just find any lip liner you like. But we're going to use this like a lipstick in a way. So we're just going to line our lips and fill them in. And then after we fill them in, we're just going to add something to it. Oh, the color, if you want to know, is rose. If you live in El Cajon, you can just go get that. Or whatever looks good on you. And it was $1, so. Look filled into me. Okay. And you can leave it like that if you would like. I don't like it. So what you can take something like a chapstick. This is, I think, $1 too. Super cheap. And go over it so it's a little more sheer, like that, and more like glossy, or not glossy, moisturized, I guess. But what I like to do is I like to take my Cargo lip color, lip gloss in Serengeti, and put it on top. It kind of has like a peachy color. It's a peachy color, so it looks really nice on top of it. This color. Do you see the difference? Not much of a difference, but I like the gloss over it. And I like this gloss because it's not sticky. It's a nice one. It's little. But it was in like a little travel bag size, so. And that's what it looks like. Also, you can line your eyes, and that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna use my e.l.f. cream liner. I'm gonna line my eyes. Okay, so I've already done one eye, and see, this is a more dramatic because I pull it down just a little bit on my lower lash line. Wait, if you want it less and you just want it a little more fun, springy kind of color, or like not very noticeable but noticeable at the same time, I guess, use the, like, I think e.l.f. makes one too in brown. But this is a brown. This is hip color Truth cream eyeliner 930 brown. It's really pretty. It looks like this. It's a really creamy brown. This one actually wasn't as dry as my black one. The black one was kind of dry. But yeah, you could use this instead if you want it more subtle, but I like the darker color. So I'll show you how to do it now. You can make it very simple and just do the black all over. I love making little wings on mine. And you can just even stop there. I usually stop there, but today I think I'm going to go all the way. And if you wanted to, I don't. I'm just lazy or something. You can set it with black powder. And for some people, I guess it's not as easy to do their liner. But I've been doing black liner since I was like 13 years old. and I'm 19, almost 20. And see, that's what it looks like on me. You just have to find what looks good on you, really. You can use a brown one, it's a little more subtle, or you can go as this dark as black, and you can go all the way. You can even make a little I don't know what you say, spike, or a little inward like wing to make it like more pointed if you want to go for that. Or you can just do very simple, you can drag it down like I am a little bit, clean it up. And then all you really have to do is use a mascara. I like the Falsies Volume Express because that's the one I have right now. I haven't really tried a new one. I really like the stiletto one I used to have. And I pull your lashes down and then pull them up. And what helps is I close my eye and drag it up. Like, helps it. And don't be upset if you mess things up, because this look is so light, you can always take it off with some lotion and then fix it. It's not that terrible. Okay, so yeah, that's the look for today. I hope you guys like it. And yeah, till next time, I'll see you guys later. Bye.